Hi everyone, in today's lesson we're going to talk more about the definite integral. So as we spoke about, the definite integral is the area bounded by the curve and the x-axis over a given interval. So for example, if I have this function x to the third plus 2x minus 5 dx with the integral between 2 and 6, that means I want to calculate the area between the x-axis and the curve of f of x equals, this should say more than just x to the third. So it should say x to the third plus 2x minus 5. So between x equals 2 and x equals 6. Fine. So part A says to estimate this area using four subintervals and a right Riemann sum. So this is review. So what I'd actually like everyone to do right now is pause the video and do part A, round your answer to the nearest thousandth, and then hit resume when you're ready for the answer. All right, this is what I got. 448 units squared. So as you can tell with the picture, this is a huge over approximation because there's a lot of spaces above the curve. So basically just to figure out where I got my values from, my heights are from the right side. So my height at 6, when I plugged 6 into the function, I got 223. My height at 5 was 130. My height at 4 was 67. And then my height at 3 was 28. So when you add all those together, you should get 448. The reason why there are ones here is because that is the width of each of these rectangles. Okay, so now something new, part B. I want to calculate the exact value of this area under the curve by evaluating the definite integral by hand. So we already know how to take an antiderivative. So what we can do now is just show you one last step of how to get an answer. So let's just write it properly and learn the steps. So we have between 2 and 6 of x to the third plus 2x minus 5 dx. So we're going to take our antiderivative by adding 1 to the power and then dividing by that power. So add 1 to this power of 3. That's going to give me 4. Divide by that power. Then my next term, if there's a power of 1, we're going to add 1 to that power. So we have 2x to the second divided by that power. And then the next one is is just 5. So we know that we could make that negative 5x to the 0. So we could add 1 to the power and then divide by that power. Now, instead of putting a plus c this time, because we have these intervals here, we need to evaluate this over the interval from 2 to 6. So the way we write that is with a bar at the end, and we put the lower number here and the upper number here. So we're going to first simplify this before we plug in. So one other step, we have x to the fourth over 4. I can't simplify that, so we can leave that. I can cross off these 2s, so I can make this x squared. I can simplify the 5 and the 1 and make that just negative 5, so minus 5x. And we're going to evaluate this from 2 to 6. So now that it's cleaned up, what we're going to do is plug in the top value and plug in the bottom value. So the formula now is just plug in the top and subtract once we plug in the bottom. So we're going to let the calculator do the work, but we have to write it on our paper first. So basically, everywhere you see an x here, here, and here, you're going to plug in the top value. So we have x to the fourth is now going to be 6 to the fourth over 4 plus 6 squared minus 5 times 6. And it would be helpful if you understood that we're separating it into two things, this thing minus the bottom. So now the bottom function, I'm plugging in 2 into here, here, and here. So same thing, I'm going to plug 2 in for x every time I see one. And then I'm going to close the parenthesis or the bracket. The brackets really are just there for you to visualize what's happening. You're getting this answer, then you're subtracting it with this answer. So what I'd like you to do now is put this into the calculator, get a number, then put this into the calculator, get a different number, and then hit resume when you're ready. Okay, so the first for the top, I got 330. And then for the bottom, I got negative 2. So be careful, we're subtracting a negative. So it's 330 minus negative 2, which will give us 332, right? They became positives. So 332 units squared is really what this area is supposed to be. So this definite integral gives you the exact area under the curve. Notice our approximation was 448. Look how far apart these numbers are. So Riemann sums were great at first before they knew that we can calculate the actual answer by hand. So what I'd like to do now with part C is actually calculate the percent error. So remember, the percent error is the actual, which is 332, minus the estimate, the Riemann sum, 448, that absolute value, of course, divided by the actual of 332, and then multiplying that by 100. So take a minute, plug that into the calculator, and then hit resume when you're ready for the answer. So I got 34.9397%. I didn't specify what to round to, so let's approximate it. Approximately 35% error. That's huge error. So when you have an over approximation, we don't know how far it could be off, so it's important that we have a better way to solve. So that better way is by using this definite integral and by plugging in the top and the bottom. All right, that's it for today. If you guys have any questions, now's a good time to jot them down. Otherwise, we'll see you in class tomorrow. Have a good night.